Artificial intelligence-powered robots just learned how to grip even ungraspable objects using an amazing technique. Carnegie Mellon University's Robotics Institute has demonstrated that even basic robotic grippers can carry out complicated tasks by taking advantage of their surroundings. These grippers are usually only used for simple tasks, such as picking up and placing objects. However, by using their surroundings, such as pushing an object against a wall or table, they are able to perform actions that were previously thought to be possible only with more advanced and costly multi-fingered artificial hands. Previous research on this method, called extrinsic dexterity, often made assumptions about how grippers would grasp items and required specific gripper designs or robot movements. Instead, these robotics researchers made this breakthrough by using artificial intelligence and the technique of extrinsic dexterity to grasp objects of various sizes, shapes, weights, and surfaces. Here's how they did it. First, they trained a neural network using reinforcement learning, where the AI system was rewarded for successful attempts at grasping an object to learn the most effective patterns of behavior through trial and error. The robotics researchers initially trained the system in a physics simulator and then tested it on a simple robot with a pincer-like grip. Next, the researchers placed objects in a bin in positions that made it difficult for the robot to grab them directly. For instance, the robot might be given an object that was too wide to be grasped by its gripper. Through reinforcement learning, it had to figure out how to push the object against the wall of the bin so that the robot could then grab it from the side. The robotics researchers initially thought the robot might try to use a scooping motion to pick up the object, similar to how humans do it. However, the artificial intelligence algorithm came up with a different solution. After pushing the object against the wall, the robot used its top finger to lift the object and then let it fall onto the bottom finger to grasp it. The robotic system was tested on various objects, including cardboard boxes, plastic bottles, a toy purse, and a container of Cool Whip. These objects varied in weight, shape, and slipperiness. They found that basic grippers were able to successfully grasp these items 78% of the time. The researchers hope to expand their findings to include a wider range of objects and scenarios in the future. They are also interested in exploring more complex tasks that can be performed with a basic gripper using their extrinsic dexterity technique. But where could this robotic gripping and manipulation technology be applied in the real world? Enter the Aeo, a humanoid AI robot that could make direct use of this kind of artificial intelligence-driven gripping technology from Aeolus Robotics. The Aeo robot was just unveiled at CES 2023 as an autonomous humanoid robot with a dual-arm design for delivery, elder care, security services, and more. The Aeo robot uses advanced deep learning artificial intelligence and sensing to adapt to its surroundings and the people nearby, ensuring safety and efficiency for everyone. And due to its onboard AI, the robot improves and learns over time as it interacts with its environment. The Aeo has two robotic arms, one of which is used to carry out important tasks such as delivery or disinfection, and the other operates elevators and opens doors without any modifications. Aeo also uses its artificial intelligence to dynamically navigate and avoid obstacles while reacting to people in real time. The robot also has additional capabilities, such as kiosk operation and disinfection using ultraviolet light, as well as the ability to open doors and ride elevators to extend its range of movement. It can be customized with plug-and-play attachments from third-party developers, such as Aeolus in Japan and Malibu AI in Taiwan. Aeolus has emphasized that Aeo's dual arms have 7 degrees of freedom, allowing the robot to perform different tasks with each hand. Aeolus Robotics says their company's aim is to develop robots that will improve the quality of life and further the positive impact that robots already have on society. In 2018, they released their first single-arm robot, which set a high standard for what a robotic assistant could accomplish. However, the company wanted to do more. Their experience deploying robots in various settings, such as senior care facilities, hospitals, public transportation offices, and hotels, is what motivated them to create the dual-arm humanoid robot. So far, the Aeo humanoid AI robot has already been deployed in Japan, Hong Kong, and Taiwan, where it provides services for major elder care providers and real estate companies. Aeolus Robotics also helps operate a hotel with a timeshare membership that includes a senior care department that combines hospitality, medical care, and nursing care. The robot is already a member of the team and plays a crucial role by completing simple tasks that allow care facility staff to have more time to interact with patients and staff. As a result, Aeolus Robotics expects both resident and patient care interaction, as well as hospitality services, to improve. Breakthrough artificial intelligence does scene synthesis from human motion. A team of researchers from Stanford University has developed a method for synthesizing scenes using only human motion trajectories, which could potentially overcome the limitations on scene diversity imposed by laboratory settings. The Summon method, which is short for scene synthesis from human motion, has been proposed, which is capable of generating a variety of possible object arrangements in a scene based on human motion trajectories. Summon works through two main steps. First, a human scene contact predictor, called contact former, decides which vertices on a human mesh are in contact with objects. Then, a scene synthesizer selects an object that fits the predicted contact points. Additionally, Summon can also add other objects to the scene that are not in contact with the human and still fit well within the scene. The contact former in Summon uses a transformer neural network to incorporate temporal information in order to improve the consistency of contact point predictions across a sequence of human motions. It's made of a GNN encoder-decoder architecture with a conditional aspect and a transformer layer. This setup allows the model to improve its prediction consistency by taking into account temporal dependencies. The model has been trained using a combination of two losses to ensure that the predicted object stays in contact with the human mesh and does not penetrate it. To achieve this, Summon adjusts the orientation of the object in contact. After the contact points have been identified, the scene synthesis model further improves the accuracy of its spatial predictions by using majority voting to determine the object class in contact. In addition to Summon, a transformer model trained on the 3D front dataset is used to predict which categories of objects will fit well in empty spaces within the scene, based on the categories of objects that are already present. Summon was compared to other baselines by presenting users with human motion sequences and the predicted objects in the scenes, and asking them to choose the most plausible and realistic placements. 74.5% of users preferred Summon over the other baselines. In summary, Summon can generate diverse human scene interaction datasets from human motion sequences, which could be useful for creating animations and CGI, among other things. The team also identified areas for future research, such as expanding Summon to include soft body contacts and addressing dynamic scenes where objects move during human motion. So far, experimental results demonstrate that Summon synthesizes feasible, plausible, and diverse scenes and has the potential to generate extensive human scene interaction data for the community. More information about the work on Summon between Stanford University and Toyota Research Institute can be found in their paper titled Scene Synthesis from Human Motion.